iconic black and orange is increasingly rare.
Number of monarchs migrating from the U.S. and Canada to Mexico has dropped to its lowest level in more than 20 years.
Could you imagine a world without them?
We used to have hundreds of millions of monarchs, and now we're down to maybe 20 to 50 million in just a few short years.
Scientists say the winged wanderers are being hit from all sides.
Monarchs face changing weather conditions, pesticides, and fewer milkweed plants.
They say if the trend continues, the only way to remember the monarchs in the Midwest may be through pictures.
Milkweed is the lifeblood of monarchs. That's what they lay their eggs on. And so if there's no milkweed, there's no monarchs.
I'm Rich Lund, and this is a video series on how to plant milkweed. This is a four-part series, and this is part three. In parts one and two, we showed you how to collect seeds, how to germinate them, and then how to get them started in some soil. And now, in part three, our plants are large enough to where they're ready to be planted somewhere, be it in your yard or maybe somewhere in nature if you prefer that. The milkweed plant that I've been using so far throughout all of this has been common milkweed, or Asclepias syriaca, and I do apologize if I totally butchered that pronunciation, but everything that we've said so far applies to just about any milkweed plant that you can get your hands on, but common milkweed is what I've been dealing with here in Michigan. When it comes to where you're going to plant it in your yard, I think something of importance is definitely selecting a spot. You want a place where it's going to get plenty of sunlight. Now, I've seen milkweed in nature grow sometimes in shaded areas, so I'm not saying that that's a deal breaker. But if you can give it more sunlight than not, then that's better. In my yard, I've selected two spots that we're going to plant our plants in our milkweed. And the only real tool that I need for this is a little bit of a gardening digging tool. And I'm going to destroy my little plastic pots that they've been growing in. So I'm going to just use scissors to cut them out. I'm sure there's another way that you could do it as far as being able to get them out. But I'm no expert on it, so I'm just going to cut through them and put them into the soil that way. Now, when you're selecting your spot for where you're going to plant these, sunlight's important. Also, of course, you don't want it to be any place where it's going to get mowed over or trampled on, and no place near where you're going to be using any type of herbicide for gardening reasons or whatnot, because the milkweed plant is pretty susceptible to them. The other thing that I would maybe consider is the root system of this plant. It spreads out in the soil, and you'll have the roots actually spring up what looks like brand new plants, even though it's all part of the same system. So there's no scientific definition of what a weed is. A weed is just any plant that's growing where you don't really want it. But milkweed is known to be a weed because of this spreading ability. So wherever you're going to plant it, just understand too that you might have some milkweed stems sprouting up from those roots after they've spread out, and just, you know, be aware of that when you're selecting a spot. So let's go ahead and take a look at our different spots that we've selected, and we'll show you how to do it. When selecting a spot in your yard, some things to consider again is how much sunlight it will receive. This spot's got direct sunlight. Also, try to plant it near some nectaring flowers. Hopefully the monarchs will come for the nectar and then also stay and lay some eggs for you. All right, so this is one of our two spots that I've selected in my yard. And you can probably immediately see, I've already got some milkweed growing here. Now, this milkweed I planted here in late August of last year, and the plants were about the size of what we're going to transfer in there now. And it's kind of interesting because about 2 weeks after having planted it in there, the plants were gone. I came into the backyard one morning, and something had chomped them. I couldn't even find where the plants were. We got some deer nearby. I don't know if the deer ate it. I don't know what happened to them. But I just thought, oh, okay, that's kind of a bummer. Our plants didn't make it. And then here in the spring, these sprouted right up. So really that root system is pretty tenacious. And even if something like that happens to your plants, as long as the roots lived, then the plant's going to make it. Now, in the first year that you plant them, don't expect them to flower. These plants are, even though they were planted last year, this is the first full year of growth for them, and they're not going to end up flowering until next year. So just be aware of that. So as you can see, and I've clearly stated, I am not a gardener, I am not a botanist, I'm no expert on this, This is where I'm going to dig in, and I'm sure that there's people out there that would find this just horrible that I haven't weeded out every single plant that's growing here, but milkweed will do fine in this kind of terrain. So I'm going to be digging some holes about 4 or 5 inches deep, just enough to transfer in our plants. And as I go to do it, I'm going to give about a foot of separation. So just digging in. All right, got a nice hole. Now we're going to take one of our pods, or one of our plants, cut into the plastic, make a little incision down there, unwrap it, you can see plenty of that root system there is really saturated. That's what we're going to get right here into the dirt. I'm going to place it in, cover it up with the soil that we dug out, spread it around there, nice loose soil. I'm not going to pack it too tight. Instead, I'm going to just water it and let the watering and just natural gravity pull the soil down, and that should be good for it. You can see I've got more than a foot in between that and the other milkweed. For my next one that I'm going to dig in, you want to give it about a foot or maybe just a wide hand's worth of space. You don't want to overcrowd them, and I'm willing to admit with the milkweed from last year, you can see how crowded it is, and that's because I didn't really pay attention to that rule. I didn't really even know about that rule, but it's doing all right. It's just, it'll be healthier of a plant if you give them enough separation, so that way they're not competing with each other for sunlight. So I get this second hole dug here, and then again, I'm gonna cut into our pod. Just sort of unwrap it. And take out our plant, root system and all. Place it in there. Cover it up with the loose soil. Get rid of any extra plant growth that's nearby just to help this not have further competitors. And I admit, maybe it was something I should have done first. But there we go.
So I've put them about a good hand width apart, not always following exactly 1 foot distance, but give them enough space that way the plant can grow on its own and isn't crowded by other milkweed plants. This will allow them to produce much larger leaves and just be an overall healthier plant. Makes it a little bit easier to maintain them too in the coming seasons. For my second spot, I chose an area in my front yard. I think we've got some work to do to change the conception of the milkweed plant. It's got the word weed right in the name, and so it's gotten some flack for this, but it really is a beautiful plant with great smelling flowers, and I want to show that off to the neighbors.
All right, so this is the second spot that I've selected. You can see it's somewhat shaded, but during a portion of the day, there's plenty of sunlight right here in this area, and this is going to be enough for those, for the milkweed to receive their sunlight. So it doesn't have to be a perfectly all sunny area. They do better in those places, but I wanted some out here in the front yard too. So I'm gonna just start by digging my first hole. And see, I've got this area a little bit better cleared out than the last one. Gonna cut into the pod. Take out my plant and plop it right in there. Some nice soil covering it, and we're good to go. I'll put a few more in this area, but the same system follows. Spread them out about roughly a foot or about a hand width away from each other. That way they've got enough room to grow.
And there you have it. Now these plants, they're going to start out small, and even in the next 2 years aren't going to get that large, but once they do start to sprout and grow, they're going to be a beautiful addition to the front yard terrain. And I've got them also next to some other nectaring flowers, so that way hopefully other butterflies are attracted to it, but it's really also just to show that this plant is something that can be in gardens. While we're talking about nectaring flowers, you may have noticed in some of my videos these are cone flowers, and butterflies love them. They are greatly attractive to just about every butterfly species here in the Midwest and in the eastern states. And also, goldfinches love the seeds from them, so it's really a great flower addition to your garden. And speaking of flowers for your garden, I want to turn you on to this book here, Life Cycles of Butterflies by Judy Burris and Wayne Richards. They have an excellent book here that shows the life cycle of nearly every butterfly in the eastern and Midwest states. But also, they've got great sections on showing you what flowers and what plants are great host plants and attractive plants to the butterflies. It's a great book. I'd pick it up if I were you. Back to our freshly transplanted milkweed. Right after you transplant them, I would water them. For the first 3 days, in fact, water them daily. This helps get some root growth going. It exposes the plants to new nutrients that are in the soil that the plant previously didn't get exposed to. This dissolves those minerals and nutrients and gets them right near the roots. They get absorbed, and also this stimulates the root growth. The roots start to grow out and branch out to find these new nutrients. So the first 3 days, give them plenty of water. Then after that, you can let nature take its course.
Okay, so you've done it. You have successfully planted your milkweed seeds either in your yard somewhere that you found, or maybe you did this same exact thing that we've been doing. You found a place in nature to put them. So, excellent. Just in closing, I'd like to bring up the idea of some seed sources that I've found online. I've been seeing more and more of these Monarch Rescue Kits, or some other name, where they are actually selling seeds to you to try to help out the monarch. You know, it seems that whenever there's a worthy cause, there's also some people trying to make a dollar off of that. And granted, there's worse things people could be selling, and maybe these companies have good-heartedness as far as wanting to help the monarch, but you don't need to spend your money on that. Everything that we've been doing here, I've been showing you, is essentially free. And so what I instead would rather you do, I'm going to refer you to Mona Miller. She's been raising monarchs and moths and other types of butterflies and family of the Lepidoptera for over 20 years, and she's got a Facebook group whose link is available right there. And if you become part of that Facebook group, they have a seed sharing program where they'll actually find out where you live and what milkweed naturally grows in your area, and they've got plenty of members that are willing to give you seeds for free too. So there's another excellent source. Just go ahead and become part of them. And one last thing too is that originally this was a three-part series, but I realized there's also a fourth part that we really should do. So next time, come the fall, we're going to have a part on how to maintain your milkweed for the winter, how to get it ready for winter, and then also how you can actually do something called rubber banding those seed pods in order to have those seeds available for next year. So thank you very much for your help in planting your milkweeds and helping out the monarch butterflies. Thanks.